Satellite in my eyes, like a diamond in the sky. How I wonder, satellite strong from the moon.
Arthur C. Clarke's concept evolves into the most significant tool of modern communication.
In 1945, Arthur C. Clarke invented the communication satellite.
On December 16th, 1961, the world turned upside down, then inside out, and I was born screaming in America.
It's Bill.
He's chosen you to do his will. You can spread the word and you're cooked to bill. So jump in the river and learn to swim. God's gonna wash away all your sins. And if you still can't see the light,
the satellite, Fat said. VALIS, Vast Active Living Intelligence System. A sufficiently advanced technology would seem to us to be a form of magic. Arthur C. Clarke has pointed that out. A wizard deals with magic, ergo a wizard is someone in possession of a highly sophisticated technology, one which baffles us.
So Philip K. Dick had this theory that time was an illusion and that we were all actually in 50 AD. And the reason he had written this book was that he had somehow momentarily punctured through this illusion, this veil of time, and what he had seen there was what was going on in the Book of Acts. And he was really into Gnosticism and this idea that this demiurge or demon had created this illusion of time to make us forget, you know, that Christ was about to return and the kingdom of God was about to arrive. And that we're all in 50 AD, and there's someone trying to make us forget, you know, that, you know, God is imminent. And that's what time is. That's what all of history is. It's just kind of this continuous, you know, daydream or distraction.
How about a positive LSD story? Wouldn't that be newsworthy just once, to base your decision on information rather than scare tactics and superstitions and lies? I think it would be newsworthy. Today, a young man on acid realized that all matter is merely energy condensed to a slow vibration, that we are all one consciousness experiencing itself subjectively. There is no such thing as death. Life is only a dream, and we're the imagination of ourselves. Here's Tom with the weather.
So we're walking along. Lady Gregory turns to me and says, "Let me explain to you the nature of the universe." Now, Philip K. Dick is right about time, but he's wrong that it's 50 AD. Actually, there's only one instant, and it's right now, and it's eternity. And it's an instant in which God is posing a question. And that question is basically, do you want to, you know, be one with eternity. You want to be in heaven.
Satellite.